हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज शेफ अजय चोपड़ा। आज यूएस पोल्ट्री के साथ हम कुछ कबाब बनाएंगे। कबाब की कहानी बहुत बड़ी है, कबाब की हिस्ट्री है, कबाब की कहानियां हैं। कहते हैं कबाब एक, किस्से अनेक, और वो किस्से आप तक मैं पहुंचाऊंगा, लेकिन साथ साथ आई एम गोना टॉक अबाउट यू नो हाउ वी गोना ट्रीट अ बर्ड लाइक दिस, व्हाट आर द वेरियस वेज टू कुक इट, व्हाट आर द वेरियस वेज टू ट्रीट इट, एंड अलोंग विद टर्की आई एम ऑल्सो गोना यूज डक। तो आज यूएस पोल्ट्री में आई हैव गॉट एन अमेजिंग ब्यूटिफुल टर्की एज वेल एज अ डक। सो टर्की का आई एम गोना मेक अ टर्की सीख कबाब, एंड विद अ डक वी गोना मेक अ लवली शामी कबाब। इट्स गोना बी सर्व विद अ अमेजिंग ग्रेट चटनी। चले शुरू करें। सो इन द बिगिनिंग आई एम गोइंग टू फर्स्ट प्रोसेस the turkey and show you what all different cuts we can produce and prepare. Well, turkey, you know, a misconception is that it's only used for Thanksgiving and Christmas parties. Yes, mostly yes. The whole world enjoys turkey during Christmas. The whole world enjoys turkey during Thanksgiving. But turkey is much more than that. Well, turkey was used in Indian cooking way back in the 16th century. Did you ever know that? No, I'm telling you. Well, the Raja Maharajas were very, very affluent when it came to hunting and when it came to game. So, they were very fond of game meat, and that's why they hunted every sort of game meat, whether it was rabbit, duck, everything. So the turkey bird comes beautifully packed right from the USA, and it actually is always temperature controlled. Matlab ye ya to ship se aa rahi hai ya fir it is coming by air. It is coming in refrigerated containers below minus 18 degree, which means that it is good to use for good 12 months. Now how to thaw a frozen bird which is this big? Sabse important part that you should never thaw it on room temperature. Never, because bacterial growth starts to happen. So how do you thaw it? Well, if you have to use the bird today, then you have to put it in the fridge, which is normal plus 5 degrees a day before. It takes 24 hours to thaw such a big bird, and even duck would take about 24 hours. Sometimes if you need it in a jiffy, then leave it under cold water and keep changing the cold water every 30 minutes, but it has to be supervised. It cannot be just left alone. So coming to the anatomy of the bird, well, this bird anatomy is quite big, but very much like a chicken. So the breast is exactly like a chicken, and the legs exactly like that. All we have to see is that it's just bigger in size. So the bird is exactly how a chicken is, but it's just maybe 4 or 5 times bigger in size. The whole bird weighs about 8 to 9 kgs, and the leg could weigh up to almost 750 to 800 grams and going all the way to about 1.25. So, you know, it's got big fatty legs. Generally, jab turkey ko roast kiya jata hai, so you roast it along with the legs always tucked in like this, and the wings are always put behind. You know, so then you will tie it up and then stuff it with whatever you want to stuff it, and then you will roast the turkey. But if you're using the turkey whole and deboning it and making a roulade, then obviously there's a different process. What I'm going to do is use the leg of the turkey for the seekh kebab, because it's got a little bit more fatty meat and it's going to be more juicier. So I'm going to use one of the legs for the seekh kebab. So the skin which joins the leg and the breast and the whole bird needs to be cut open. So now this skin just needs to be cut open, and the bone, you just have to start feeling it and start going through it. Now this joint needs to be cut open, and there is this bone which connects it. It's just a straight bone. You can hear the bone with the knife.
And now here, just like the chicken, it has an oyster which needs to be cut open. Well, right from the days of my college, I loved being in the butchery shop and doing all of this.
So basically the bird needs to be disjointed, and the cuts are going to be very similar to that of deboning a chicken. So there is an oyster here. You need to go with the tip of your knife for the oyster, cut it open, break a leg. It's just a funny one to say. And then just keep feeling the bone. Two turkey legs. Now, whatever meat is on the carcass can be used in multiple ways. Well, you can actually remove all the meat and make small tikkis out of it. You can actually roast the entire carcass and make a beautiful jus out of it, or do a stock out of it. You can do loads of things with it. But basically, this part now could be actually used to just roast it up as a whole. So if I'm using the legs for the kebab, this can be used for a roast. You know, a family of four can easily eat through this. Well, this is done, and it also has a lot of offals and fat inside it. So, you know, all of that can be used for various things. So I'll keep talking about it as we go. So just going to remove the skin and make it boneless. Again, same procedure for using the skin off. So, there you go. Now, the bone structure is exactly similar to that of a chicken.
Just in the center, go with a nice gash. Now, all you have to do is just feel the bone. See how I'm holding my knife? Just feel the bone. Here you go. You can see the bone here. Obviously, there is more flesh than chicken, so you got to be a little patient. Whatever small strips are coming out, with the heel of a knife, just scrape off the flesh from the bone. Okay. The tendons are obviously a bit harder, and your knife has to be super sharp. Well, that's a given. There you go, boneless, nice piece of turkey leg. Now these sinews and the extra layer of skin needs to go off, because this is just a protective layer and wouldn't do anything to the flavor. Okay, clean it up. Now I'm going to just cut them in small pieces to marinate it for the seekh kebab. So turkey leg meat is somewhat similar texture to lamb shoulder meat, maybe a little softer than that. So the cooking time is obviously not going to be as much as chicken, but a little more than that. So it's got to be a little more than cooking chicken. A tender piece of lamb and turkey leg have a similar cooking time. Just make sure that there are no tendons or no soft cartilages, because your Sikh kebab, you don't want to taste any of that. Now the entire turkey leg, which is boneless, cleaned up, is now going to get marinated for the Sikh kebab. So I'm putting in a little bit of garlic. Some ginger. Some chopped coriander. A few sprigs of mint. I'm just going to break it because they all are going to go through the mincer. So which is all right. A green chili, some salt, some red chili powder, and some garam masala powder. All of this marinated really well. And then we're going to mince it.
आप इसमें जो भी additions करना चाहें कर सकते हैं. There are 100 ways to make a Sikh kebab. But I'm actually going to make a gilafi Sikh kebab. Gilaf का मतलब होता है cover, और cover बनेगा capsicum से और onion से और kalonji से. So here is the basic marination, which is again I'm repeating: ginger, garlic, which is roughly chopped, green chili, chopped coriander, mint, salt, red chili powder, and garam masala. अब इसके बाद इसे मिंस किया जाएगा दो बार, बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट अ नाइस स्मूथ मिंस. Now I'm going to go once again with this mixture. So the Sikh kebab mixture is absolutely ready. अब इसका गिलाफ ready करो. Well, गिलाफ में I'm going to add capsicum, which is red, yellow and green. उनके छोटे छोटे dices, थोड़ा सा प्याज और थोड़ा सा kalonji. इसको एक covering की तरह लगाएंगे Sikh kebab पे. And I don't have a tandoor at home, but I'm going to do it on a tawa. Well, it's going to be a little different. अब देखते जाइए कैसे.
Now this is twice minced. इसको अच्छी तरह से mix कर लेंगे. And now we're going to get on to making the seekh kebab. For the gilaf, I've got some red, yellow, green peppers, some chopped onion. I'm going to add some kalonji to it. And a special spice mix, which is made with cloves and peppercorns. I'm just going to mix this up. Now, ideally for a tandoori skewer, you would use a thick skewer for Sikh kebab, but since I'm doing it on the tawa, I'm going to just make a double skewer and just look at my hands. I'm going to keep flattening it out, keep taking it behind. Your hands must be moist at all times. And I'm keeping the skewers in such a manner that the meat is in the center. So a nice smooth skewer. Now just take a little bit of this mixture and go on all directions. Doesn't this look beautiful?
खैर हमने आपको बताया था कि कबाब एक किस्से अनेक. सीख कबाब के जो किस्से हैं ना बहुत निराले हैं. अब सीख कबाब इनिशियली वाज ऑलवेज मेड विद मटन, लेकिन बाद में हर चीज का सीख कबाब बन लग गया. वेजिटेरियन सीख कबाब भी बनता है, चिकन का भी बनता है, टर्की का हम बना रहे हैं. सो सीख कबाब इज नथिंग बट जस्ट मिन्स मीट विच इज फ्लेवर्ड. And the word kebab, actually, it's not Indian. It comes from Turkey. In the early 13th century, the Turkish kings used to actually, you know, eat this meat. So they, when they were on wars, they would actually take their swords, do some game meats, kill some animals, chop them up, marinate them, and on their swords they would actually barbecue. So that whole culture started to go across, and when the king of Persia started to take over the entire Mediterranean and then eventually the Indus Valley as well, that's how kebabs traveled to Afghanistan as well as India. And we know that the kebab history actually comes from the Afghani border. So that's why the Northwest Frontier Cuisine celebrates a lot of kebabs. And kebabs ek aisi cheez hai jo samay ke saath saath, you know, badha hai. It has evolved. So whether you talk about kebabs from Lucknow or we talk about kebabs from the Nizams, it has evolved. और उसकी कहानियां बहुत सारी हैं. मैं कहानियां सुनाना आपको जरूर चाहूँ. खैर इसे पकाते हैं पहले. So on a flat pan, just little bit of oil. I'm going to sear it on all the sides. It's how simple it is. So kebab की कहानियां क्या है? खैर जो सीख कबाब की कहानी तो मैं आपको सुना दी. अब इसके अलावा तीन और कबाब है. एक है गलौटी कबाब और एक है काकोरी कबाब. दोनों भाई बहन. कहानी goes like this, that नवाब सिराजुद्दौला from लखनऊ, he was somebody who was very shocking. He wanted to eat good food always, and he was the one who actually came up with this kakori kebab recipe. But on the other side, which was in Delhi, Bahadur Shah Zafar, unke daant khatam ho gaye the, and he also was a foodie, and he told his chefs that boss, I want to eat kebab. Kebab mujhe milte rehne chahiye, kyunki bhaiya sadiyon se yahi to seekha hai, matlab kebab khate wale hain, and suddenly if your teeth are gone, then how are you going to chew the kebab? So the chewing of kebabs was replaced बाय मिंसिंग। अब गलौटी कबाब का जो मिंस है ना वो 10 बार किया जाता है, 10 बार, बिकॉज देर आर साइंटिफिकली ऑल्सो, मतलब आप टेक्निकली आप कॉलेज में पढ़ेंगे दैट देर टू वेज टू लिटरली व्हाट यू कॉल टेंडराइज मीट, टू वेज टू टेंडराइज मीट, वन इज ऑब्वियसली मिंसिंग एंड द अदर वन इज एक्चुअली पुटिंग अ टेंडराइजर टू इट। So whether we talk about using raw papaya to meat to tenderize it, or we talk about mincing it, whatever we are doing is basically cutting down the small sinews in the meat and making it nice and very very juicy. But here this was more than juicy, this had to be melting in the mouth, and for melting in the mouth texture you either need to actually marinate it for a long long time with that tenderizer, or you want to mince it many times. So galauti kabab is minced 10 times so that the meat becomes really very very soft and creamy. और उसके बाद उसके अंदर काजू और प्याज, ब्राउन अनियन का पेस्ट, ना एवरीथिंग इन दैट देन इज ओवर एंड अबव ऑफ दैट विच इज एक्चुअली वेरी वेरी सॉफ्ट. सो द galauti kabab mixture इज एक्चुअली when you take it in your hand and feel it, it actually is like a paste, it's like a pate. So the French would call it a pate. It actually is a lovely kebab. Now, similar texture of a galauti is now taken on a sariya and cooked on a bhatti, and that is kakori. Then, uske aage badha dori kebab. Well, kakori kebab ko dori se bandha, and then the dori actually gets opened in front of the king or the guest now, and that is how the kebabs evolved over a period of time. So, bahut sari kahaniyan hai kebab ke bare mein. I would really recommend that you read up on kebabs, because the very fact that Indian food has a lot of history behind it, and this history has equal value. This history has equal value than the technique. So, जहाँ पर technique important है, वहाँ पर history भी important है, because कहानियों के साथ साथ हमारा खाना आ गया है, and that is why it is very important to know in the entirety of it. चलिए, ये जो कबाब है ना, इन्हें अब हमें ओवन में फिनिश करना पड़ेगा, बिकॉज ऑफ द सिंपल फैक्ट दैट तवे पे ये बाहर की लेयर तो अच्छे से कुक हो जाएगी, बट अंदर की लेयर कुक नहीं होगी. सो वील हैव टू पुट इट इन द ओवन एट 180 डिग्रीज फॉर अबाउट 5 to 6 मिनट्स, एंड देन आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट इट. सो लेट्स सेंड दिस टू द ओवन. सो प्रीहीटेड ओवन एट 180 डिग्रीज, I'm going to cook this for about 5 to 7 minutes. Nice and crispy, it's done. Let's plate it. So this amazing Sikh kebab is ready from the oven, and now we can take it out. And I'm going to give it a beautiful salad along with it. Nice squeeze of lime and maybe a lime for garnish. Well, who would have thought that this amazing looking gilafi Sikh kebab is actually from US Turkey? It is, because this is purely Indian kebab. Hai, mast hai, tasty hai. Aapko ise seekhna hai, ise try karna hai, aur phir uske baad jab hum ye khatam karenge session, khub sare questions puchne hain. So this is ready. I'm going to give you a quick, lovely glance.